In the last video, I showed you what an AI agent actually is and how it's different from chatbot or an automation workflow. If you missed that, go check it out first. But if you're ready to build your own agent that reads emails and replies for you while you're sleeping, this is the one you've been waiting for. Let's do it. No fluff, no code, just clicks. We're going to build a real AI agent using N8N, Gmail, and Google Sheets. It's going to watch for incoming requests from your inbox, pull the most common questions and answers from a spreadsheet, write a personalized reply using ChatGPT, and send it all without you lifting a finger. It's the exact system I use for some of my clients, and you'll be able to set it up under 15 minutes. Time to build your first agent. All right, so let's get started in N8N. So if you haven't done that yet, create a trial account. You have 2 weeks free, and then we're gonna be creating our first workflow. So hit that big button in the top right corner here. So you'll start from nothing. So what we wanna build here is the ability to read emails from Gmail, turn it into that AI agent, and then actually return the final outcome, which is the response back in the Gmail thread. So let's start with the Gmail trigger. So trigger is what triggers the workflow. I already have the Gmail connected here. So if that's your first time, you're gonna want to, I think there's a button that says new or create new credential. Actually, it's right here. And from there, it's gonna ask you to log into Google. And so you're gonna be able to do that. And it's just a few clicks and then that's it. You have Gmail set up. So that will show up exactly like me right here. Then it's gonna pull every minute, which is good enough for here. But in case you wanna do it less often, you can also decide to do that or decide some custom polling mechanism. And that's it for now. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna send myself an email from my personal account to this is my work account. And we're gonna be fetching the results in 1 second. All right, so I got the email, let's give it a try. So I'm gonna hit that fetch test event. So that's gonna grab the latest email. So as you can see here, this is the actual content that I sent, not looking at the subject line at all. It's only looking at the content of the email. It's very basic, but this is just an easy example here. I'm gonna do a pin on the data. So if I don't want it to trigger on any other email that I receive going forward, I want it to just pin to that specific email. What's good here is that you have the thread ID directly. So that's what we're gonna be using later on to actually respond to that email. So I just pinned it. There's a little warning here and that's expected. You have that little pin here, which is gonna be helpful going forward. Now we're gonna be adding our AI agent node. There's two ways to do the integration. You can do a chat, which is not what we're doing. We will be doing that in future versions. But right now in a very basic one, we're gonna be defining that specific set of prompts that we want. So keep in mind, there's a set of two prompts that you need to pass. There's the user message, which is exactly what the email says. And then separately, we're gonna be adding the system message. So this is more of a general instruction of how to react and who you're gonna be an assistant in this case, and how to behave based on the actual user message that you're getting. So for the system message, it defaults to your helpful assistant. We want something a little bit more advanced. So I generated something with ChatGPT. You can do the same. I'm gonna just paste that in here. So it just says you're a helpful professional, virtual customer service, name of the company. I just picked SaaS company. It could be your actual company. From here, I state what kind of knowledge base we're gonna be using. So in here, I have an FAQ in the spreadsheet that I'll show you in a second. It says to always base your answer on that. From there, you can be extremely specific. In my case, what I'm saying is I want it to be very clear. And so if you don't know the answer, don't make anything up. I want to say that you will escalate the case to a specialist if you don't know. Well, the guidelines, clear, friendly, concise, and then a set of other things, just to, what I would want my assistant to say. And then what I specifically added at the end myself is I want to format the answer in a very specific way, which is a typical email structure. So I even provided an example. So if someone asked that question, I want it to return, hi, thank you for reaching out, different paragraphs, so that the output is very structured in an email fashion. You don't want that single line email. It feels very weird. So I wanted to specifically emphasize on that. Now, what's interesting is because we just created the Gmail trigger before, you actually see all of the data that we're receiving from Gmail. So, and that's why N8N is actually pretty cool, is you can just drag and drop the information that you want. And so in the user message that I was mentioning before, we're actually gonna take the information from that Gmail thread. And this is just an example, but obviously as you run that at scale, it's not going to be pinned down to that specific thread. It's going to be the email that you want. So in here, the important piece is you're going to want to toggle from fixed to expression. The big difference is fixed is always the same information, similar to that message. In here, we want it to be more dynamic. So every time there's a new email, you want it to change. So that's why it needs to be an expression here. So I'm going to just drag and drop, and that's it. It's going to already find that value, and it's even showing me the example live, which is awesome. And that's kind of it for my AI agent. Now remember, what I said before is in order to hire a good AI agent, you need to pick the right brain. So I'm gonna pick a specific model that we want. There's many, many in there. I will pick OpenAI, but there's some free credits that you should definitely take advantage of, especially for a free trial. So you should take a look at that. I just clicked and I got that free. I think it's 100 credits. But then obviously if you're gonna be running something bigger after that, you'll want to actually connect it to an OpenAI account that will have credits that you can use. But for now, this is perfect to get started. It's not the most powerful model, it's GPT-4o mini, not the best, but it will definitely do the job here, and that's kind of perfect. So that's all you need to pass in. It knows exactly how to connect. We're gonna want to set up the memory in a second, but first I'm gonna connect the tool. So in the tool here, we're gonna be using Google Sheets. As I mentioned before, we're actually gonna be using this random AI generated FAQ. None of it is correct, but I just wanted to have something a bit realistic about what people might be asking and what the answer is. It's not really good data, to be honest. This is very short. It doesn't give a lot of description. So if that was actually something you wanted to run, you would want to have way better data. And so that's something I'll cover in a second, but better your input data is, the better the response is going to be. So that's important to keep in mind. This is just a sample to prove my point here. And here, in the question that I'm asking in the email, you actually see this is the perfect question that I asked. I asked how to report a bug, and there's a specific email, bugs@sascompany.com. So I'm gonna wanna see the AI respond with that specific format. I did not ask the question in the exact same format that the question is. I did not specifically ask that in that phrasing. So we're gonna wanna see that it still finds the right answer for me and it's generating the right format. Now, keep in mind, this is a very simple example. This is for a small subset of data you have. You can have that in the Google Sheet. If you had much larger sets of data, like a lot of PDFs, a lot of company data, if you want to even plug in your previous Zendesk tickets or previous tickets in general, you're going to want to go and look at my video on RAG and specifically how to use embeddings, etc., vector database. We're going to get there in a future video, but I just want you to know this is just for the sake of simplicity. That's why I've set up that Google Sheet. But if you wanted something more advanced, you're probably gonna wanna be looking at a vector database here. So here we are, right? So I did something similar here. I needed to create a new credential in order to have the Google Sheet account. Same thing, you sign in into Google and then you're kind of done. I'm leaving everything default here. Operation, I wanna get everything, but in some cases you might wanna have some other integrations, but we just wanna get the entire content from here. Then from the document list, you can either paste the URL or from the list, it's already going to look at the more recent ones. All right, so it found that specific example, the FAQ knowledge base. That's the same document that I was showing you. Then there's only one sheet on that one, but if you had multiple, it would also support that. So it's just going to be looking at that as a specific tool in the toolbox for the AI agent to actually respond. And there we have it. So as of right now, it has no memory. So if there was a long back and forth over Gmail, it would kind of start over every single time because it doesn't remember what happened in the last thread. So that's an important thing to keep in mind. So what we're going to want to do is actually to test the AI agent as is, and then we can add memory to see how that works. So you see the input is on the left here with the Gmail trigger, and then we're going to see the output being generated here. All right, so that's perfect. That was very quick. And as you can see, it is formatted correctly. The backslash N is actually a way to have a new line. So it's exactly what it is here. It says hi, two new lines. Thank you for reaching out. It's exactly the format that I wanted, and it's giving me the exact information that I wanted. So it's returning bugs at SaaS company, your input is valuable, etc. It's being extremely friendly, which is what we want. So it worked. The AI agent returned the exact information that I wanted. Now, as I said before, we're going to want to add the memory. You see the little checks here. The checks actually indicate that it went through those different tools and used the model, and that everything looks good. We're going to be adding a very simple memory. We could have memory that has that is a bit more powerful here, but that is not the intent. We're going to keep something very simple. It's in memory. It doesn't have to be too crazy. So same here, I'm not using a chat. So I'm just going to define what I want to define. So the key for the memory is, how do you want to define how unique your memory is? So you don't want memory across multiple emails. You want memory within one thread, right? You don't want to remember previous conversations that didn't happen with the same customer. So it's important to have a good key that is not going to drive the memory crazy. So we're going to use the thread ID. That's the best way to get started. It's going to remember within the thread, but if someone else reaches out about a whole different question, it's not going to mix things up. So there we go. Simple memory is in here. And there you go. You hired your first AI agent, right? So I'm going to run it again because it added the memory now, and it's going to probably do something similar. Keep in mind, AI is never returning the same answer. So you might get slightly different verbiage every time you run it. That's expected, that's normal, and that's for the most part fine, because it still gets the right answer in right context. It's just that the phrasing is a bit different every time. So you have that in here, it's still the right answer, that's perfect, and still the right backslash n, so the right new lines, that's perfect. So it returned exactly what we wanted, and it ran through all of this, as you can see here. Now all we have left is to actually connect the output, which is the response. So we want to generate a Gmail response, Gmail, and reply to a message. Now this is all still the same, right? And it's even better because now you have the output of the AI agent. You still have the Gmail trigger. You still have access to all that data. But what you want in this specific case, you still want that Gmail account. You want to send a message. You want a reply action. So we're gonna leave everything in here. And now it's asking you, okay, now where do you want me to send that message? So same thing, it's not gonna be fixed. We're gonna want to have something more dynamic. Every single time you have a new email, a new thread, you're going to want to actually have something different. So I'm going to switch to expression, and then I'm going to drag and drop the thread ID. So the thread is exactly like in a Gmail thread where it'll shows up as a one unique thread, and you want to respond to that. You don't want to start a new email. It feels kind of weird. So that's exactly what we're doing. It finds exactly what we want in here, the exact syntax that it needs. You don't have to worry about it. You just need to drag and drop and you're done. So now it knows where to respond. We just need to tell it, what do you respond? So there's two types to send. To keep it simple, I'm gonna just do plain text. We could generate HTML. It might be a bit more advanced. So this example, that's perfect in here. We have the output, same thing. I'm gonna drag the output in the message here. It automatically switches to expression and it shares the answer here. So we're gonna be testing that step. So remember, it already tested the trigger. It tested the AI agent. Now the very last step is going to be to actually reply. So I'm going to hit test and it's actually going to send the email, and then I can go into my inbox and show you guys what that looks like. That was quick. Didn't have to wait or pause. I just got the notification. I just realized if you want to make this a bit better, you might want to also send the sender name. The email came directly as a email address. I'll show you what I mean in a second. All right, so there you go. So you see my original email in here. This is just what I reported. That's from my personal account. And then I sent it, and almost within a few minutes, I got the response. I did not use the first name of the person, although we did have that. So I could have used that. We could do another version with that. But as is, this is what you got. Thank you for reaching out. Very friendly to start. It's giving you straight the answer here, a few paragraphs. It feels very good. So what I mentioned before is that we did not send the sender name in here. So the issue with that is that it's coming as the email. I probably would want to personalize and say customer service or something like that. Actually, let's try it again. So let's go back in here and add the sender name. You could put customer service, or you could actually put an actual person's name if you want to make it feel less robotic. Just gonna send that through again and see what happens. So there we go. It sent the exact same message again. Because I rerun the specific reply, I did not rerun the entire AI agent. So it's the exact same content. It's just that instead of coming from the sender, my email address, it's actually coming from customer service. So it feels definitely more professional, and that's definitely the better way to do that. So there you have it. You have your very first AI agent. You know how to use N8N, and you can test the entire flow if you want with this big button in here. Save it up, change the name to customer service. And in future videos, we can expand on that, or we might be creating entire new AI agents from scratch. And then you have all the list of execution. So every single time you ran it, it's gonna show in here. So that was it. Congrats, you did it. All right, so now we've built your first AI agent, but this isn't magic. Your instructions aren't good, your agent will not be good either. So remember, garbage in, garbage out. I've said that in many videos, and I will continue to say that. Whether you're a team of one or part of a big organization, AI agents can help you reclaim time and focus on work that actually matters. If you want to build one, reach out to me. If you want more examples, hit subscribe. I'll be sharing more in the next few weeks. And if you've ever wanted to automate a repetitive part of your job, drop it in the comments, and I'll reply with some ideas on how you can build your custom agent.